by guys with bows and arrows. This is much more impressive to the Romans. But also, even tigers. The Romans never even conquered India. 2,000 years ago, these trade routes exist. Imagine how much a tiger cost compared to just a slave who was a gladiator. Now, we also have to switch off our human self. When Nero died, well, the Roman period, Remus, 600... Dictator, he actually did some really good things. He was a man of the people. The politicians hated him, but the mob loved him because he created. See some pussycats down there as well, because the cats of Rome are very famous. I can see, well, 1, 2, 3, 4 Right, look at the trunk. Doesn't it look way too long? The trunk is about 50% too long, but it's a lovely elephant, and it's carrying on its back a genuine Egyptian obelisk. We have 12 Egyptian obelisks, you know, the obelisks, the great big spikes of granite covered in hieroglyphs. We used to have 30 in Rome, because when the Romans conquered Egypt, they brought home trophies and souvenirs. And these obelisks have been in Rome for 2,000 years, and they've only been in Egypt for maybe 1,000 or 1,500 years before that. Church, because it had a big inside space. So in the year 609, over 1,400 years ago, they turned down to go into the Pantheon, which means Roman street level must be quite a long way below. Fountain from the 1600s, another Egyptian obelisk there. But if you look at the front of the Pantheon, these columns are something like 17 meters high, and each one is a single piece of granite. So they're not built in sections.
Each one is a single piece of granite. Just imagine the writing up the top. That's
not now,
who was consul 3 times, built this, 1st century BC.
And they used to write their name on the front of it just to make sure everyone knew they'd done it. And then in the triangle up above, that's not all bullet holes up there. Those are the little holes where multicoloured marble and bronze statues of all the different Roman gods would have been clipped in, because this was a temple to all the gods. Doors are original. This is the office of the Prime Minister. So if you like, that's the equivalent of number 10 Downing Street in London, where the Prime Minister is. So this is the Trevi Fountain, the most famous fountain in Rome. It was built in the 1700s, so by our standards, you know, it's quite new, it's only 250 years old. It took 30 years to build, and it was built by the popes, because back in the 1700s, the popes still ruled.
Yes, that's it there. Yeah.
Gracias.